car.
What's up, Jenny?
Check 10 o'clock high.
I have you.
Never mind, it's the moon.
It's gonna be like, there's a celestial object at over a couple thousand, but other than that, I got nothing.
Contact about 60 miles out.
Yeah, that looks like our friend.
Contact sitting on waypoint 1, so I'm assuming that's our escort.
Yep, that's our guy.
I'm up here basically line of rest to the left of nearby.
Yeah, I'm catching up for mine.
I'm having some nav issues. I'm gonna turn my infrareds off.
Must be a silent mission, huh?
SRS.
Yep.
I'm coming up off your guys' right side. Jenny, you still below me to my left?
Yeah, I'm about line of rest, probably about, I don't know, 1 mile.
Yeah, I'm coming back.
Okay, I think I'm coming up between you two, Gunny and your wife.
I've got the tanker locked. We're just going to rejoin on him.
Yep, we're just going to rejoin on the S3.
Contact 80 miles out. Okay, so Gunny's went vertical. Near, am I to your 3 o'clock or 9 o'clock?
I don't see. Were you near Gunny?
I was trailing him.
Okay, so nearby should be up your 3, I think.
Yeah, I'm basically right above you right now. I'm at 19,000.
Do you guys still have your lights on?
Affirmative. Heading is 291, right?
For you, yeah, it's going to be 291.
I have no contact.
I have a contact at the 310 for 10 miles.
Okay, I'm going to be heading 310.
Joined on the right side.
Roger.
Contact right at the edge of the radar.
What altitude do you guys have Pontiac at?
About 13,000.
Okay. Cut up on his right side high, 14,000.
I'm going to move my altitude 20K. I don't know where the hell I am. Alright, I'm staying in the international waters.
Where we go, I'd select waypoint 2 and start using that as a reference.
I am unable to use my radio. I can't seem to get my waypoints working. You're right. I've tried it with the right DDI and the center DDI. I can't get sequencer or waypoints to work. I think I've got a damaged bird. Got a check trim.
By that, do you mean did you turn your INS on?
Standby. Yeah, INS is set to nav.
Alright. So what does your HSI show?
Standby, let me balance out.
Overshoot you and the tanker?
I'm just pulling up in his back right quarter now. I got one guy here off the left.
That's me.
Okay, I have working on the left DDI. I have check trim up on the warning symbols.
Well, that means you didn't set your takeoff trim before takeoff, but you can't fix that now, so don't worry about it.
That's interesting, because I remember specifically setting it to at least 12 degrees.
You needed 17, but don't worry about it now.
Bingo. There's our problem. I scraped the damn tail.
That's not so much that you scraped the tail. In fact, if anything, 12 degrees trim would cause the opposite. But what does your HSI say? Can you box the waypoint?
I actually have access to waypoint. I'm setting up on waypoint two now.
We're about 40 miles south of waypoint two.
I'm five miles back. I'll increase airspeed to 350.
This guy's pretty slow, so you should have plenty of time.
Recommended elevation?
We're at about 12,000 feet.
Okay. The Google Doc said 20,000. Got it. Thank you.
Fridge, I'm not visual with you, so I don't know where you are.
Yeah, I'm off your right side. A little bit distant, 500 meters, or 500 feet, maybe 1,000, I'm not sure. I see your blind down there close to the tanker. Yeah, I'm off your right, closing in.
You ever hear the story, Gunny, of the F-14 pilot who landed his plane without a stick?
No.
Okay, we got time. So, F-14 pilot, he's doing his pre-flight, and he notices the plane feels like the stabilators feel a little rough when he's maneuvering the stick, but he wants to fly today, so he decides, fuck it, it's okay, we'll just fly. Gets in the air, goes to go do something, he's kind of coming back to the boat. All of a sudden, he hears a weird noise, and then the plane just tries to do a full forward stick down. He catches it, and he tries to fight it, he's trying to fight it, it's taking all of his strength to keep it doing whatnot. He's trying to pull back on it, he's radioing emergency, and he's pulling back so hard on the stick that the fiberglass thing they make the actual like stick out of shatters in his hand. So he catches it again, and now he's using, like, the nub, the little thing below it, trying to fly the plane like that. He's declaring all sorts of emergencies and whatnot. This was in a book, and it's being told third hand by an admiral. He manages to get it back on the deck, like, using just a little stub and degraded control surfaces. He's able to fly it back, and he catches, like, a two-wire or something, and he gets down. The admiral's like, well, what happened to him? He should get a medal for that. Like, that's a distinguished flying cross for sure. carrier, or the guy in charge of the airing, was like, well, yeah, that's probably worth a DFC. However, I should have thrown his ass in the brig for taking that plane up when he knew there was something wrong with the flight control cert. So I figured not giving him the DFC cancels out me not throwing his ass in check.
It's pretty awesome.
This is way more fun with all the civ traffic. So if we pick up anything coming out of Bandar Abbas, I'm going to have you guys, I'll call Wendigo do it, but I want you guys to intercept it, at least in the beginning. If you can't get on it by the time it gets close to the E3, I'll lend a hand.
Sounds good.
Whareagle's 18 miles out.
From us or the waypoint?
Waypoint.
You are ahead of us then.
Well, damn it!
Whoa! The S3 just decided to die.
Yeah, I'm gonna hold this altitude.
Yeah, that's fine. Maintain the airspeed and you should be able to keep up.
What airspeed are you all at? 320.
I leave it up to you guys. We can go back and start it over, or we can go back and just try and practice case threes.
Well, I'm good with... What time is it? I'm good probably with case threes. It's almost 11 here.
All right, Fridge. Do you guys want to head back to the boat? Tech and should be... CLS 15. We'll run this one again next.
Cool. You think the, will the enemy plane still show up or not? Because it's dead.
Oh, the Fulcrum showed up. It's off our nose if you want to go kill it. I don't know what the F-14s are going to do. I think that trigger might have been dependent on the actual escort plane being in that trigger zone. But they'll also probably defend themselves if you want to run like 100 miles west.
I'm kind of curious to see if this thing will shoot at me or not.
It will not.
We're going to head back to the carrier.
Yep. I ruined it. I killed my own creation.
No, this is awesome. I'm just mad at myself for not getting any adept.
No, but see, that's what's good about this, right? We've got time to practice at nighttime, which is difficult, so, you know, this is good.
This is the hardest thing I've ever done.
Yup.
Wait till you land.
Near escorted me through that for two bolters last week.
Incident.
Do it.
We're not surprised.
who needs visual confirmation when you got M120s?
Not you. Also, Gunny, if you really want to start a fight, there's a four-ship of F-14s out to the west, and they will defend themselves. They may not kick stuff off initially, but I don't have the same ROE on them.
Is the BRC 028?
It's going to be something in that neighborhood, but remember, you don't fly BRC Ace 3.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, straight into territory.
Time to go, boys.
No, that's not a Sam Lodge. That is a MUD from a fan song and a Big Bird radar because Gunny is flying all of the machine. Spooky, scary MiG-29 is still up.
For the ILS landing, ILS channel 15, turn it on, box the ILS on the HSI.
Yep.
Thank you.
Regan?
Buddy.
Here's my final put challenge. Can you guys rejoin on one another?
Not a chance.
I mean, you're within about 5 miles of Fridge.
What's your altitude, Whareagle?
21.7. Airspeed 3.5. I am 79 miles out from waypoint zero. Heading 136.
Miles from you. I don't have the gas to catch up. is channel 18 the OS?
It is. I think I'm just excited for once I get to land first.
Don't blow it.
Well, it's gonna be interesting. My jet has severely degraded longitudinal stability.
I think the tanker's on 254.
The big tanker's on 254. The one gunny will be on 264.
Okay.
Okay, it looks like I'm 20 miles out. I'm going to start a descent down to 12,000 feet? 6,000 feet? I have a carrier in sight.
10 miles out.
There you go.
Buddy.
Sorry, boss. Looking for a tanker.
You're fine.
Okay, if I'm going to do this right, how do I set the radios?
Navigation assistance.
Altitude.
Hello. for Bolter.
I'm setting up. I'm eight miles out.
It's all right. I'll extend back.
I'm at 6.5, starting my turn back onto the bus.
I'm three miles out. I caught a wire. Getting the hell out of the ray. And I just frickin' stunk the nose into the drink, so...
Heading down, you should have spacing, and if I bolter, I can go around and extend. Yep.
God. At least they landed. Everybody just roll your eyes.
Forward, 1-4. Request takeoff.
I'm 5 miles out on the moon tail. F.
Clear the foul line.
Okay, I'm gonna take about 8,000 pounds and just come down.
make it to about 6, the timing works great for it.
Landing. Forward, 1-2, request landing.
Call that a K-68.
It looked good to me.
A little low, floated, and then kind of dropped it at the end, but it worked. It's a PS4 controller, so I mean, what are you going to add?
I think that's called a cut, power, whatever. No grade, but made it back.
Again, I'm not sure how many F-18 pilots are flying with their dual shock.
This is exactly what happened to me. Watch.
Cannot see the carrier. There it is. He was nice enough to turn off his lights after you landed.
That was me. I left my lights on.
No, the carrier turned off the lights.
Oh, that's not good.
Is there any way I could beg the dot Miz?
Is it possible that we might be able to make a library of some of these dot Miz's? They're so creative, but I'd like to honestly practice between Wednesdays.
I would love that.
Thank you.
Sure, no problem.
Okay, gentlemen, I'm gonna log off. I do appreciate it. I've gotta get up, go teach, and
I had fun. God, I landed on carrier deck at night.
Good job.
Yeah, it's a good time tonight. I'm gonna get off as well.
Thanks, everybody.
I'm gonna go do coding shit.
You are awesome.
I wish they didn't turn the lights off on the carrier after you land.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense to do that.
Because, like, I'm in a place now I have no idea which way to turn.
Just turn on your NVGs.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I mean, in reality, you'd have a 19-year-old with glow wands, lightsabers, you know, shepherding you around, and you really wouldn't have a say in the matter. But...
True.
They also don't turn off the deck lights after you. That's an artifact of like flankers ATC.
It's definitely challenging trying to rejoin in the nighttime. With the radar, it makes it easier.